First, let's go to rewind back our mind that during this Thamding initiation, Thamding has got the wings of Garuda, right?
Yes.
And so if you realize, during the time, during the initiation, Rinpoche did say the word Jhado a few times, right? That's not referring to himself. It's referring, actually, Jhado Rinpoche, the Jhado means Garuda King, King Garuda Mountain. Yeah, Do means Great Mountain. Yeah, so Rinpoche is actually the sixth incarnation of the monastery of the Garuda Mountain. Yeah, so he's, and also he's very, very close to this the Idam High River. And also, so to me, it means very, very special for somebody who's from the Garuda Mountain, giving us Thamding initiation, which will teach us how to pray with the Garudas, activity with Garudas. So this is very, very meaningful. Next is we have to pray for Rinpoche's long life. To pray for Rinpoche's long life, we also have to pray for His Holiness Sobing Dalai Lama's long life, because Dalai Lama and Rinpoche are very, very close. Yeah, so usually like this, friends, old friends and relative who are very, very close, really must all, not pray for one, you have to pray for all of them. Yeah, all of them must live a long, healthy life. So this is very important. So we must pray for Rinpoche's long and a healthy life. Okay? And also not forget, we must also pray for Geshe Tashi, because Geshe Tashi say, everybody only pray for Rinpoche, how about me? So in the mind, we must also have to pray for Geshe Tashi, because Geshe Tashi, 40 over years, together with Rinpoche, look after Rinpoche, helping Rinpoche, this really also must, you must remember, take good care, Geshe-la, okay?
Yes.
Yeah, so Rinpoche will request you, please, that this temple is yours. Okay? Yeah. So now no more Jhado Monastery, you have Thekchen Choling. Okay, so you see there on the screen, that's the four line short long Rinpoche's long life prayer. So Rinpoche's name is Tenzin Zhongwei. I better see from here what I see from the screen. Yeah, Tenzin Zhongwei. So this is Rinpoche's short long life prayer. Geshe-la, Nathan didn't do his homework because Geshe-la did translate into broken English. I asked Nathan to do the better English and asking who to check. Somebody to check, right? But somehow it didn't fulfill, so we just recite in the short one. First, we recite a short long life prayer, then recite the long, long life prayer in English. I tell you why, I explain to you why. First recite the short one, then recite the long one. Not the long one, then the short one. Because you want, when you recite the long life prayer, you want the guru to come very quickly, right? So short. Then when come, then stay long time. You don't want the beginning is very long, then after that, the result is very short, right? Correct? So first recite the short one, then recite the long, long one. Okay? So nonetheless, so the short one will recite in Tibetan because the English is not available. Yeah? And then we recite the one in English. Okay?
Yes.
So please recite together. Sangha Devadavata Tese Kebo Shambhe Dogo Tege Jovata Nega Kato Dono Sho. Do you have the English long one?
Yes.
Yeah? So, okay. From the oceanic treasury, from the auspicious gathering for 100,000 good deeds, Wealth form is the awakened body which pleasures in the thousand acts of life. By bringing it to mind, may we be sustained by He who grants supreme immortal life. The protector of the unfortified land of great bliss, sovereign of those who with the wisdom of all the nations is condensed within one mass of life. The ocean of mandalas which fulfills the wishes of the two aims, the great one of three wonders who is found to be definitely be the eyes of supreme emanation, I supplicate, so that you may uphold its entirety in the teaching of the great eyes of this good in God. The Lord of the sages, in accordance with your aspiration, you are my teaching in the guides of several worlds. O Lord of the mighty master, O source of benefit and happiness, I pray for help to believe from. Gathering well the innumerable rivers of much study, and filled so as to swell the precious gold of contemplation itself. Your profound depths of meditation sway ever rolling waves of confidence. As by which an ocean of Dharma, I pray a life to be lived from. Rain clouds made for the learning and righteousness gathered in the skies and span. So great of the explanation, debate, and conversation. A fresh field we pray to the happiness of the teachings and the beings, for you cause the flowers. Master who is quite supreme, I pray your life to be in God. Your understanding you are a good time, so far over. Compassionate ones who takes care of the rooms to perfection. Through ability you are master who accomplishes the source of true beings. Incomparable glorious Guru, I pray your life to be in God. The mountain of your discernment approaches the heights of all kindness. And you wave the white thread of compassion everywhere. With the wind of the heroic activities of all your instructions, I rise up my teaching of teachers, I pray your life be made fun. May your exquisite ethical discipline, glorious love of the Holy Spirit, may your exquisite altruistic use of the three spheres flourish. May your exquisite life and lotus feet remain good for a long time. May such exquisite related activity accomplish my true project and its guidance. By the blessings of the ocean of nectars beyond measure, and the power of causality and interdependence beyond imagination, may there be stable life of this protector conscious beings beyond imagination. May there be fortunate ways of all time beyond imagination. All these. So, today I want to share a little bit what happened in my experience. You want to hear?
Yes.
So, Rinpoche always asked me, do I know the name of the Buddhas in Chinese? So I went to find my cupboard library upstairs. And then I found one book. And then that book has a collection of all the gurus and the Buddhas and the Bodhisattvas. So I thought it's a Rinjung Gyatsa. So we brought it down and Rinpoche said, okay, sit down and look through with me. So then confirmed, Rinpoche tell me, oh, there is this deity here. That means this is not Rinjung Gyatsa. Rinpoche memorized the whole Rinjung Gyatsa, you know. And then after that, then we looked through together. And then because Rinpoche cannot read the Chinese, he cannot read the English, and he cannot read, I don't think he can read the Mongolian, but he definitely can read the Tibetan. He read the Tibetan faster than I read the Chinese and the English. Then Rinpoche tell me, oh, this one is mystic. Because this deity, the hand is supposed to be doing this and this, and holding this and this, not this one. This one definitely mystic. Yeah. So really, this is Buddha. Yeah, so we are very, very blessed. We are very, very blessed that Guru Dorje Chang is here to give. And also thank you to Geshe Tashi for 25 years of fighting. 25 years of friendly fighting. Yeah, then God, because Rinpoche accept my request for Rinjung Gyatsa through kindness of Geshe-la. So Geshe-la saying, you want to repay kindness, bring him to eat roti prata. Yeah, because the last time Geshe-la was here, Geshe-la when he went back to Mongolia and India, he dreamt of eating roti prata with me 6 times. Yeah, and each time Gishila eat 6 to 6 roti prata. Yeah. So please, you don't believe him. Oh, I'm only eating 2. Yeah, I'm only eating 2. Yeah. He eats 6 big ones. Okay, so we have to rejoice. You know, body, speech, mind have to make. Body, I'm here. Obeisance, speech, I'm praising. Mind, I'm telling everybody, offer you a lot of food and also. So please, best offering to Rinpoche and Gishila. Is to really, we have to practice your smile. That is your best smile, best offering, smiling. Today also very, very special, as you know, this Maitreya Buddha here.
Yes.
I'm going to show Rinpoche the original photo when it first came, how the man who took the statue to repair, when he brought it back to the factory, he said, this is one of the worst thing that can ever happen to him because it's so old. It's like this statue of Rinpoche, 200 over years old, but we repair to make new. Repair. So this is what our practice is supposed to be like this. We receive something very old, don't keep to make it old and useless. Your practice is to revive it. Okay? To revive it. Yeah, Geshe-la say, Rinpoche, I am very fortunate in Mongolia. I offer Rinpoche my Dharma room. And Rinpoche very kindly, we exchange bell, doje, and Dharma room. So Geshe-la was saying that you're very fortunate, you're very clever and fortunate. I didn't think of being clever. Geshe-la gave me dirty looks, giving me dirty looks, because Rinpoche's bell, doje, Dharma room, he says 200 over years old. So that Dharma room got a fire puja and had something burning drop on it, so that there was a hole through the skin. So then I was thinking, you know, every single original thing there is precious, right? So I removed everything there and kept the skin, the old brocade, everything will keep as history, the blessing. The Dharma room itself, the body. I'm going to send through Sherry. She's going to carry something very important to Nepal and to refurbish, to clad in gold, okay, and put new skin. So something very ancient to become usable again. This is personally my practice. Okay, personally my practice. Make something old and people already give up, revive and give it life again. Yeah. So this is my practice. This is what I like. So similarly, this is a very ancient practice, ancient text, ancient tradition passed to you. You make it come alive again. Okay? Now, of course, there's no time for me to teach you every single sadhana, what to do. I think for auspiciousness, one day I will do together sadhana with you for the Tara that give wealth. I'm sure that day, may all people come. Then the condition is you must memorize the 21 Princess Tara. Then I teach you all what visualization this, that. Okay? Okay. So we have to recite the same.
Song yeah, song,
Thank you, Rinpoche.